Welcome to the Rain 72 MK2 feature overview. In this video, we'll be taking a deep dive into the functions and controls of the most advanced Rain performance mixer. We'll be covering everything from the basic mixer functions to the advanced independent pad modes, as well as the many ways to use both the built-in Flex Effects and Serato DJ Pro Effects to enhance your DJ performance. At its very core, the 72 MK2 is a two-channel advanced control and performance mixer with built-in effects and a full-color multi-touch screen that displays your current track info, waveforms, library, touchable XY effects, and gives you access to the mixer's many customizable features. With its all-metal construction, the 72 MK2 is built for battle. The steel carry handles protect the front panel, and the effects paddles are die-cast aluminum. It can be used with most any combination of audio sources, including turntables, media players, mixers, drum machines, or microphones. But it's the mixer's advanced integration with Serato DJ where it truly shines. Let's load up a track. Once connected to Serato DJ Pro, press the View button to see a list of crates and tracks. Use the Browse encoder to scroll up and down. The Back button will toggle between crate and track windows and is also used to expand or collapse crates within a folder. Once you found the track you want to play, simply press the Browse encoder to load to that deck. The Browse encoder is touch sensitive for quick access to the library view and will automatically return to the track view after your track is loaded and you release the encoder. For instant doubles, simply double press the scroll encoder. This will load the same track that's playing on the other deck and from the same time. The track view will display the waveforms of your two tracks and critical track status information such as BPM, time remaining, sync status, musical key, key lock, and pitch and time status. You can scrub through the track by grabbing and moving the playhead on the track overview. This can be disabled in the Serato DJ Pro settings menu by checking Disable Needle Search. To zoom in and out of the displayed waveform, simply pinch and adjust. The Pitch and Time plugin for Serato is included free with the 72 MK2. To turn it on for either track, press Shift plus key to show the Pitch and Time icons, then press the icons to activate Pitch and Time. In the upper corners, you'll see the key information. You have the option of either viewing in the Camelot system or standard musical notation. You can find that option in the Serato's settings menu under Library and Display. Press on the key icon to enter key sync mode, press again to disengage. In the lower corners, you'll find the sync controls. Pressing the sync icon will sync that track's BPM to the opposite track and both sync icons will turn blue. Press Shift plus the sync icon to disengage sync. Sync on or off can also be assigned to the Hot Cue pad mode parameter buttons, which we will cover later. At the top of each channel is the input selection. While using Serato DJ Pro, you'll want to select either USB A or B, depending on which USB input your computer is connected to. The dual USB inputs make DJ handoffs as easy as switching the input selection encoder. Each channel has inputs for two additional analog sources as well, both of which can be used for DVS inputs for Serato DJ Pro. One is a dedicated line level input for CD or media players, and one is switchable between line level and phono level input for traditional turntables. If you're using a traditional turntable, you can adjust your cartridge's input sensitivity in the menu to dial in the appropriate setting for your equipment. Moving down from there, you'll find the input level. Adjust this to match the input levels of your sources and to make sure you're not clipping. Next, we have a 3-band full-kill EQ. Turning a band all the way down will completely remove those frequencies from your track. You can adjust the width of the mid-frequency band to suit your taste. This is found in the menu under Mixer Settings, then Deck Settings. each deck has a dedicated hardware, full kill, low pass, and high pass filter. Turn to the left for low pass and turn to the right for high pass. The filter resonance of each channel can be adjusted in the menu under mixer settings, then filter setup. And because these are built-in hardware filters, they'll work with any audio source. The pan of each deck is adjustable in the menu under mixer settings, then deck settings. To swap the faders of channels 1 and 2, you can engage the switch on the front panel labeled deck swap. The 72 MK2 is fitted with three new ultralight Mag4 faders. This new high-quality design is our lightest and most buttery feeling yet. Utilizing Rain exclusive patented technology, tension can be adjusted two ways on the crossfader. On the front panel, you'll find the external crossfader tension adjust to personalize the fader feel for the in-the-moment situations. Tension can also be permanently adjusted on all faders by moving a friction-free second super magnet closer to or farther away from the rail with a set screw. Since this design doesn't rely on friction or tension, the performance won't degrade over time. All the faders on the mixer are interchangeable and replaceable. In addition, contour adjustments and reverse switches for each fader can also be found on the front panel. And to truly customize your faders, the cut-in point can be precisely refined in the settings menu under main menu, then cut-in adjust. Also, all of these custom settings can be found and saved in the Rain app as well, so you can save and recall settings from mixer to mixer. Above each of the channel faders and the session input are cue preview buttons. You can adjust the level and blend of the cue mix as well as engage the cue split button to send the cue mix to the left ear and the program mix to the right. You can also adjust the tone settings for your headphones in the menu under mixer settings and then headphone setup. There are 1/8 inch and 1/4 inch headphone outputs on the front panel. The 72 Mark II has two combination XLR and 1/4 inch microphone inputs. Mic 1 controls are found on the front panel and include level, tone, an on-off button, auto-ducking, and a dedicated echo. The echo amount can be dialed in on the front panel. Hold down the on button for 3 seconds to engage the auto-duck. This will automatically lower the volume of your mix while you're speaking. Mic 2 controls can be found on the front panel and include an on-off switch, level, and tone. If you're recording your set, you have the option of removing Mic 1 from the recording. You can find this option under Mixer Setting, Audio Out, Clean Feed. You also have the option to use the mic inputs with a mono line level source, such as a drum machine or keyboards. The mic line switches can be found on the back panel next to their respective inputs. The 72 MK2 features dedicated hardware controls for the sampler and Serato DJ Pro. These include a volume control, a high pass and low pass filter, and a button to send the sampler through whatever effects bank the sampler is routed to. We'll get into more detail on the sampler and effects later. The Rain 72 MK2 has an input for a 3-button foot switch. You can assign these switches to either effect bank or up to 3 assignable parameters inside Serato. The foot switch can be set up in the menu under foot switch. The session input allows a second mixer or stereo audio source into your 72 MK2. There's a dedicated level control and a cue button to preview the session input. The session output is designed for mix teams to route team audio through a master mixer or to send an additional stereo master output to an external source like a sound card for streaming. The 72 Mark II has XLR main outputs and balanced 1/4 inch TRS booth outputs with controls on the top panel. You can choose between stereo and mono outputs in the menu under Mixer Settings, Audio Output. The left-right balance can be adjusted here as well. The outputs feature ultra-high-quality audio circuitry designed and engineered in Seattle, Washington. The 72 MK2 has a powerhouse of post-fader effects available that can be run in three different ways. First, by using the toggle switches in effects section. Second, taking advantage of the built-in capacitive touchscreen with finger gestures. And finally, with two instant access pad modes. With toggle effects, you can stack up to 6 serrato effects and 2 internal flex effects simultaneously to give you powerful and creative options for the 2 available effects banks. To start using effects, press the effects button to access the effects view. Here is where you can assign, route, and set up effects banks. At the top of the screen is where you can see the effect bank's routing assignments. Below that are the time division settings for both serrato effects in orange and flex effects in blue. Underneath those are the effect slots. The top 3 orange slots are for serrato effects, and the bottom blue slots are for the rain internal flex effects. At the bottom are the deck arrows used to assign a flex effects to a touch effect. The BPM is displayed here as well. Select the effects you want to activate on the bank by pressing the button's text to its corresponding slot. The button will light up to indicate that it's active. It's important to note that you won't hear any effect unless the effect paddles are in the on position. To change a parameter, tap the slot on the touchscreen so you can see a white border. Then, turn the bank A or B encoder of the bank you're working with. The flex effects have a dedicated depth encoder, so you can adjust your depth setting quickly without having to access the effects menu. To change the assigned flex effect, tap the slot on the screen and press the parameter encoder down. The effect button will blink. Turn the encoder to scroll through your effects and press the encoder down to select the new effect. To change the time division of your effect, tap on the serrato or flex effect time divisions and turn the parameter encoder. There are 2 separate effects banks that can be routed to one or both decks, as well as a sampler. On the effects page, tap the top of the screen to open the routing page. The left side is effects bank A and the right side is B. Route either bank to deck 1, 2, or the sampler. You could, for example, use bank A for both your decks and bank B for the sampler, or send both banks to both decks for full flexibility. Simply click OK when all set. The 2 aluminum paddles are used to engage the effects for each deck. The paddles are deck specific and will activate whichever banks are assigned to that deck. Push the paddle forward to latch the effect, or pull the paddles to momentarily activate the effect. If you would prefer the toggle to latch when down, the paddle plate can be removed and the paddles can then be rotated 180 degrees. As an alternative, you may wish to leave the paddles latched in the on position and then use the wet and dry mix control to gradually bring effects in and out. You can use up to 3 serrato effects per bank for a total of 6 serrato effects per deck. If serrato effects are in single effect mode, you can assign 1 effect per bank with 3 tweakable parameters. If serrato effects are in multi-effect mode, you can select 3 different effects and adjust the parameters per channel. The internal flex effects are a suite of effects built into the 72 MK2 hardware. This means in addition to using the flex effects with Serato DJ Pro Audio, they'll also work with audio sources connected to the deck inputs like traditional vinyl. There is a flex effect slot in each of the 2 effect banks, so you can have up to 2 flex effects active at the same time. The flex effects have additional parameters that can be adjusted by double tapping the effect slot. You can also limit the available effects to just your favorites in the menu options under flex effects. Simply turn off any of the effects you'd like to remove from the list. This will make it faster to assign your favorite effects. The flex effects are also all post-fader. This means that when you turn down the fader, the effects will still ring out. Let's have a listen to some of the flex effects. The touch effects allow you to use the touchscreen as a single-touch dynamic performance tool by combining a flex effect with a combo filter on an XY grid. Press the touch effects button to activate the XY grid on the touchscreen. Then, slide your finger across the display. The up and down axis is a low-pass, high-pass filter, while the left and right axis will control the time division or decay of whichever effect bank is assigned to the touch effects in the effects page. Choose which flex effect you'd like to assign by first selecting the current effect on the touchscreen. You'll see a white arrow appear to the left. Hold down the respective bank button and you'll see the blue flex effect button flash. Now, use the bank encoder to choose which effect you'd like and press down on the bank encoder to select that effect. The pads do not have to be engaged for the touch effects to work. The fader effects are gate patterns that simulate scratching crossfader cuts. There are 8 patterns to choose from. Press the sampler fader button twice until the pads turn green. Now, press any of the pads to activate a gate pattern while the sound is playing. The pad effects are 4 internal effects that you can access at any time from the pads. To use the pad effects, press the roll pad effects button twice until the button turns yellow. The top row offers vinyl break, backspin, gate, and echo. Select the effect you'd like to use, then press the bottom row to activate that effect in 1 of 4 time divisions. These are fixed time divisions that sync to the BPM of the current track. As a bonus, the echo effect can be combined with other effects. The 72 MK2 has 8 Akai Professional MPC style pads per deck that function independently on each channel. There are 15 different pad modes and functions, from familiar cue points and loops to unique fader effects and customizable MIDI modes. When you select a pad mode, the screen will display which mode is engaged and what each pad does. This will automatically disappear after a few seconds. To keep the display up, simply touch the pad mode header for a few seconds. Tap once to minimize. Each pad set also has 2 parameter controls. With the 72 MK2, Rain is introducing the ability to have these parameter controls alternatively offer silent cue, sync, instant doubles, or custom MIDI settings. These settings can be exclusive to pad modes that don't currently use the parameter controls or be set to override at all times. To change the function of the parameter buttons, simply go to Mixer Settings, then Parameter Setup. You can assign and access up to 8 cue points per deck when cue mode is engaged. To add a cue point, press any unlit pad at the point in the track that you'd like to save. If Quantize is selected in Serato, the cue point will snap to the nearest grid. Press a lit cue button to return to that point. Any cue point saved in Serato DJ Pro will appear when you load the track next and will also follow the color chosen in Serato. To delete a cue point, simply press Shift in the corresponding pad. If you look at the track overview, you will also see your cue points there. When in pitch play mode, each pad plays the track from a hot cue at a different pitch. First, let's choose a cue point. Press Shift and select a cue point. Each pad now corresponds to a specific sound by semitone. The pad with the original pitch will be lit white. You can change the range of pitches with the parameter buttons. To adjust the key of the current track up or down, press Shift and use the parameter buttons. The Serato Pitch and Time plugin is included free with the 72 MK2 and must be installed to use pitch play. In auto loop mode, each of the pads trigger or release an auto loop of a different length. The parameter buttons will double or half the length of the playing loop. To shift the auto loop backwards or forwards in time, press Shift and the parameter buttons respectively. Serato's loop grid determines the size of the loops available. Slide the loop grid with the parameter buttons and the pad layout will move to match it. Additional loop control can be done using the bank AB encoder while the screen is in the waveform view. Rotating the bank encoder will adjust the loop length. Pressing the encoder down will engage the loop. Pressing again will release the loop. If you have the beat jump controls enabled in Serato, the top four pads will be used for the auto loop controls, the bottom for beat jump. The two orange pads will half or double the length of the beats. The two red pads will execute the beat jump in either direction. In manual loop mode, you can create, save, and recall loops. There are two banks of four loops that you can access. To create a loop, press pad 5 to set the loop endpoint, then pad 6 to set the out point and activate the loop. You can adjust the in or the out point by holding pad 5 or 6 and moving the platter. Button 7 toggles the activation state of your loop on or off. This can also be done by pressing the bank button. To save the loop, while the loop is active, press an unlit pad in the top row. You can do this regardless of how the loop was created. To select a saved loop, press the lit pad in the top row. To jump to that loop, press pad 8. The parameter buttons will double or half the length of the playing loop. To shift the loop forwards or backwards in time, press Shift and the parameter buttons. If you want to delete a saved loop, hold Shift and press the lit pad in the top row. Hold Shift and press the pad mode button 2 to access the second bank of loops. In roll mode, each pad triggers a momentary loop roll. To trigger a loop roll, press and hold the pad. Releasing the pad stops the loop roll and resumes playback where the playhead would be had you not triggered the loop roll. The parameter buttons will double or half the length of the loop. To shift the loop backwards or forwards in time, hold Shift and press the parameter buttons. The software's loop grid determines the size of the loops available. Shift the loop grid with the parameter buttons, and the pad layout will shift to match it. In sampler mode, the pads will launch samples assigned in the Serato DJ Pro sampler. To enter sampler mode, press sampler/fader effect so that it lights purple. To play a sample, press a lit pad. The pad will flash as the sample plays. To stop playback of a sample, hold Shift and press the pad again. To cycle through the sample banks, press the parameter buttons. To cycle through the sampler outputs, hold Shift and press the parameter buttons. If you have purchased the Serato Flip Expansion Pack, you can access the flip controls by holding Shift and pressing sampler/fader effects. If you have not purchased the Flip Expansion Pack, this will be available as a custom pad mode. To enter slicer mode, press slicer transport so that it lights red. In slicer mode, the 8 pads represent 8 sequential 1-beat slices of the beat grid. The playing slice is represented by the blue lit pad. The light will move through the pads as it progresses through each 8 slice phrase. Your track must have a correctly set beat grid for this mode to work properly. Press a pad to play that slice. When you release the pad, your track resumes playback where the playhead would be had you not triggered the slice. To decrease or increase the size of the slices, press the parameter buttons. The 72 MK2 has a transport mode, so you can perform with Serato DJ Pro even without any additional control hardware or turntables. In the top row, you have pitch bend and BPM pitch slider controls. In the bottom row, you'll find a key lock toggle, sync, and the transport functionality, cue, and play and pause. To switch between internal and relative mode, press Shift and Pad 5. Switching to relative mode will allow you to resume control of playback with Control Vinyl or Control CDs. In addition to the standard pad modes, you can also create up to 3 customized pad sets using Serato DJ Pro's MIDI mapping feature. To create a custom pad set, hold Shift and press mode button 1, 3, or 4 if you don't have flip enabled. Open the setup menu in Serato DJ Pro and select MIDI. Select 72 and make sure that Allow Serato DJ Hardware Remapping is enabled. Then close the setup menu. In the main Serato DJ Pro window, click the MIDI button at the top of the screen and begin mapping. Click a feature in Serato DJ Pro. Then touch or move a control on your hardware to map the feature to that control. See the Serato DJ Pro manual for more information on MIDI mapping. The 72 MK2 settings gives you access to more features and adjustments to customize the mixer. Hold down the menu/view button for a few seconds and you'll be presented with this menu. Let's go through each one. Mixer settings holds all the options for the mixer. Audio out allows you to change from stereo to mono for the main output, as well as the panning from left to right. Deck settings 1 and 2 adjust the turntable phono input sensitivity and the tone crossover values for the EQ. The DVS input option allows you to change from either the phono line input to the auxiliary input, meaning you can still have turntables plugged in as well as a separate DVS input on the auxiliary channel. Finally, there are the left and the right panning controls. The filter setup allows you to adjust the resonance for all 3 hardware filters, as well as adjust the high and the low band's extreme end to be either a full cut or a frequency value of your choice. In the pad setup, you can control the sensitivity, as well as the daytime mode setting, which increases the brightness of the pad colors. Parameter setup gives you the ability to change what the cue mode parameter buttons do for each deck. Button mode allows you to change these buttons to perform a number of options. In normal, the buttons are idle and pressing them won't do anything. In sync mode, the left parameter button will turn off sync, the right button will turn sync on. In silent cue, the right button turns silent cue mode on. This will mute the individual channel and become active again as soon as a cue is selected, like this. You can also turn silent cue off at any time by also pressing the left parameter button. Instant doubles. Both buttons will select the song playing on the other deck, loading and playing from the same place in the song on that deck. Finally, custom mode will allow you to MIDI map these buttons in Serato DJ Pro to the functions of your choice. In the override section, selecting on, the parameter buttons will perform the button mode action you take for all pad modes. Turning the override off means only the cue pad mode parameter buttons will perform the button mode action, leaving the other pad modes to function as expected. Headphone setup gives you tone control over the headphone output. Mic 1 setup has a variety of options to control the echo feedback, the ducking threshold and hold, as well as options to route Mic 1 as a clean feed. Selecting this on will stop the Mic 1 channel going to the booth and session output, as well as to the Serato recording. The last option in the mixer settings is the touch effects setup. This option allows you to change the touch effects button to either activate the touch effects screen or to be a tap button to manually tap in the BPM value for the effects. FlexFX gives you the options to adjust the internal hardware FlexFX. The list of effects gives you a couple of options. On the left of each effect, you can click on the wrench icon and go in and adjust the values for each one. On the right is a green dot. This indicates the effect is an active option in the effects performance menu. Should you wish to remove the effect from the list, just hit the green dot to hide it. Adjust each fader's cut-in adjustment in this menu. Simply select a fader from the touchscreen, then move the physical fader to the desired position and select Set. The foot switch option enables you to set up MIDI or mixer control functions for up to 3 switches. In display options, you can control the screen brightness, turn screen touch on or off, toggle the pad display on or off, and also adjust which screen is the default for when you turn on the 72 MK2 mixer. And finally, you'll notice there is a restore defaults option at the bottom of some of the menus. Engaging this option will reset the mixer to its default settings. In addition to the onboard mixer settings, we also have a desktop app for Windows and Mac OS. This allows you to save your mixer setup preferences to your computer and upload them to the mixer at gig time. That means that no matter which 72 MK2 mixer you're performing on, it will be set up perfectly to your liking. Well, that covers everything you need to know about the Rain 72 MK2 mixer. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe, and also follow us on all socials.